So, one of the great traditions we've got here in this country, July the 4th, besides what you'll see from President Trump at the big parade in D.C. tomorrow, is the Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest. Well, Joey Chestnut, who did win it last year, he's won it more than once, has not really distinguished himself as the greatest eater in the world, not just hot dogs. This guy's won Hooters Celebrity Wings Contest. No matter what you put in front of this guy, he eats it. Now, last year, he set a record. 74 hot dogs consumed in just 10 minutes en route to another eating championship. So he looks, of course, to defend that championship tomorrow at Nathan's. Action gets underway at 10 o'clock. Do you realize, Bernie, like 35,000 people show up to watch this? 35,000.
I am aware of it, and I understand it. If I could, I'd be there my damn self.
You would?
Not really. I would watch it on TV, though. I will watch it on TV.
Well, so will
on ESPN,
I.
Yeah.
So will millions of Americans, and here he is. You know, listen, if you're ever the best at what you do, no matter what it is, that's pretty cool. The best eater in the world and reigning Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Champ, back for a second year in a row on the Bernie and Sid Show, Joey Chestnut. Good morning, Joey.
Good morning. Great to be on with you again.
Nice to have you back. You were with us last year. We were in Atlantic City. You did a terrific job. All right, so we'll go over some of the same things we talked about last year, which is, as you get ready for this big eating competition tomorrow, today, the day before, what does Joey Chestnut do?
Oh, my God. I'm going to do some yoga, drink some water. I might cheat a little bit and have a little bit of a salad today, but it's going to be almost no solid food. And just lots of liquid, and I just want to make sure I'm stretched and loose and empty and ready to really just push my body super hard tomorrow. And there's going to be, like you said, 35,000 people cheering, and hopefully they can cheer, and I can give them a new record.
So at 6'1", Joey Chestnut, you do look slim, but you do weigh 230 pounds. Now, prior to the event, are you really, like, ravenous? I don't want to say starving, but, I mean, very, very hungry?
I'm pretty hungry. It's weird. I've learned to ignore the feeling of hunger. So I've practiced going days without eating, and then I think if you can ignore the feeling of hunger, you can ignore the feeling of full. And I just going with the mentality of like I know I'm empty, and even if I feel full, I'm not full. I know that I have this capacity of 75, 76 hot dogs, and. I'm going to make my body work for me.
Yeah, I think the misconception.
Rhythm.
The misconception, Joe, is that if you're heavier, it'll be good for you tomorrow. I mean, I remember before you, the guy Kobayashi, guy weighed like 50 pounds soaking wet. And the guy also won just like you.
Yeah, he had like a crazy six pack. And I don't have a six pack. I don't think I ever will. But You have to be healthy, and I've learned that the healthier I am, the harder I can push my body. So it's a weird double-edged sword, also, because you have to practice by eating a lot, also.
Now,
over the years, I've had to really perfect my method, and we'll work hard to stay healthy.
You've been you're a three-time champion now. I think 3 years in a row, 74 hot dogs, as Sid mentioned last year. Now, did you feel slighted that you were not invited to the White House after the winning this great championship? And would you go if you win tomorrow?
I've always felt a little bad. I thought Obama was going to invite me, and never did. I thought Trump would invite me, never did.
Anybody
gets invited to the White House. Well, if anybody gets invited to the White House, I think they should go. But it's never happened to me.
Never happened to you.
That ain't
well,
right.
You know, listen, I used to do sports talk radio, and there were these arguments all the time. Car racing, for example. That's not a sport. Those aren't athletes. Golf. A lot of people don't think golfers are athletes. Now, you are considered the best eater in the world. Do you consider yourself a world-class athlete?
Oh, my God. I have to.
Really?
I think if you talk to a NASCAR driver, Indy car driver, they consider themselves athletes. And the amount of physical training, it may not be, it's not the same as throwing a baseball, it's not the same as running, but when you see everybody at the top of their game, they put in a lot of energy, and I have to consider myself an athlete because I put in so much thought, and I see how my body responds to the training and stimulus, and it makes it a Yeah, so there's no other nothing else I can call myself. But I can see how people sometimes are critical of things they don't understand. And if you watch the contest and see how hard the top eaters are pushing, I think you'll have to call us athletes.
No doubt about it. I put you in that category. World-class athlete, Joey Chestnut, again tomorrow, Coney Island, 11 o'clock. The world-famous 4th of July International Hot Dog Eating Contest. You can watch it on ESPN or you can go see it. And let me ask you this, Joey Chestnut. It's not just men. It's women, and which is amazing. Some of them are fairly slight-looking ladies. But do you think it's fair that this year one of the female competitors is Stormy Daniels?
Who?
What?
I didn't know that. But
now listen,
I know women do love to eat, I'm happy that they're finally sitting at the table and not acting like they don't like to eat.
No, they like to eat. So the question for you here is: after the event is over, whether you eat 74 hot dogs, 77 hot dogs, how do you feel? I mean, I like hot dogs. I'll go to a Yankee game or a Met game. I'll have one or two, and I'll be farting and burping for like 5 hours. How do you feel after 74 hot dogs? Yeah, that's right.
It takes 2 days to start feeling good. I'm after the contest, I'm doing interviews for like 45 minutes, and you can tell I'm just like getting more and more drunk on the food. My interviews get worse, and I'm just thirsty and so tired.
You don't get diarrhea?
Interviews.
You don't get diarrhea?
Oh, it's going to come in rounds. So first thing, I'm just tired, and then I'm thirsty, right. And then I wake up, and when nature's calling, it's running. And things are coming, and it's not pretty.
I gotta think, like, whole hot dogs come out of your ass, no? Whole hot dogs.
Whole hot dogs. That colon's, it's working.
So when you practice, do you pull some like bulimic thing where you force yourself to vomit, that type of thing? You know what I mean?
Usually, by the time I'm done, I can tell right away if it's settling deep. If it's settling deep, it's almost pointless to try to get sick because it's just harder. It's easy. In some years where I can tell where I'm going to get sick because either I'm dehydrated or there's just something wrong with my body, it's not digesting. But I can tell right away. If the food's settling deep, and wow. you can tell too. If I'm not smiling after the contest,
right?
You can say, "Oh, Joey's not looking good. He's gonna have to take some off the top." But,
so
usually it settles well, and that's how I know I can eat more the next time. It's a matter of just building tolerance.
Nice. So what's at stake here, and we'll wrap it up with this, the great Joey Chestnut, the world's best eater, reigning champ, hot dogs, Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest, talking about money, prizes, well, what do you win if, in fact, you win tomorrow?
Oh, there's the eternal glory. It's the mustard yellow belt. There's a $10,000 prize, and throughout the year, I do a bunch of appearances for Nathan's, which is the best hot dog out there, and the cash prize isn't amazing, but it's the biggest contest in the world, and you're competing against something everybody in the world does, and to like wake up in the morning and say, oh my God, I am the best at it. It feels good.
Definitely. Listen, Joey Chestnut, you are truly a national treasure, and we wish you all the luck tomorrow in Coney Island, again at the world famous 4th of July Hot Dog Eating Contest, 11 o'clock on ESPN. Folks, check him out. Joey, good luck to you, bud.
Thank you so much. Happy 4th.
You too, Joe. Thank you. Joey Chestnut.